Before we have a look at building agents, I do want to show you another very common use case of using chat flows. This project might not be the most fancy of projects, but this is a super common use case of using large language models, and it's definitely a skill that you need to learn. At some point, you will be expected to work with unstructured data. Now, that could be pretty much anything. It could be a simple sentence or something complex like an invoice. For example, this example invoice that contains the company information, the client's details, the invoice items, the invoice number, and the total amounts. So in your project, you might be expected to extract certain information from a document like this, and that's very hard to do using traditional coding methods. But thankfully, large language models are very good at making sense of the content of this document. And by the way, it doesn't have to be a PDF document. We can upload images like screenshots and JPEG images as well. And we can then ask the large language model to extract certain information. But more importantly, is we do want to return that information in a very specific format. Let's have a look at how we can build this. Back in Flowise, let's create a new chat flow and let's call it Invoice Analyzer. Let's save this and let's start by adding a new node. Then under chains, let's add an LLM chain. This chain takes in a large language model. We can also assign a prompt template, but more importantly, we can also assign an output parser. So it's this output parser that will allow us to specify the exact output in which we expect this response. Let's start by assigning our large language model. So let's go to chat models and I'll add the chat OpenAI node. I'll select my credentials. I'm going to leave it on GPT-40 mini. I'll set the temperature as something like 0.2. because I don't want to give this model too much creativity. And let's attach this to our chain. As I mentioned earlier, we can also upload images simply by enabling this toggle. But do take note that if you do want to use image uploads, then you do need to select a model with vision capabilities. So for OpenAI, that would be the GPT-4 vision preview model. I'll simply disable this for now. And now let's add our prompt template. So under prompts, let's add a prompt template. And let's also go ahead and attach this prompt template to our chain. Now, we can use a prompt template to provide additional instructions to our model. It's almost like the system prompt on the chat models. Now, for the prompt template, we can actually expand this and let's add some instructions. So let's have a look at this. From this invoice, I actually want to extract the invoice number. Let's also extract something like the customer number. And let's also extract the gross amount, including VAT. So all we have to do is say something like, extract the following information from the provided invoice. And that would be the invoice number. Let's also extract the customer number. And finally, we can also extract the gross amount, including VAT. If we simply run this chat with this information, the large language model actually won't have a view of the invoice. So in order to include the invoice content within this prompt, we need to use a variable. Let me show you how that works. So we can say something like invoice content, and now we can inject any content into this prompt by using curly braces. And within these curly braces, we can enter any variable name like invoice. Let's save this. And now let's click on Format Prompt Values. Now we can see that variable name and we can assign a value to this variable by clicking on Edit. When we click on this box, we can now attach any value to this variable, like the user's question, and that's effectively the question from the chat window. We can also assign the chat history, and what we're looking for is the file attachment. Let's select this option, and let's close this pop-up. We can save this chat flow, and if we open the chat window, we won't see any option to upload a file yet. That is because we need to go to Settings, Configuration, File Upload, and let's enable File Uploads. We can now save this, close the pop-up, and now in the chat window, we do have the ability to upload files. So I'm going to upload that PDF file example. And by the way, any invoice will work. You can simply go on Google and just search for sample invoice PDF. Now let's simply say something like hello, and it really doesn't matter what we send, we simply want to trigger this chain. And in the response, we get the invoice number, which seems correct. We get the customer number as 12345, which also seems correct. And for the gross amount, including VAT, it should be 45353. which it is. Now, the intent of building these type of chains is for this chain to be called from outside of Flowise by some external system to extract this information, and then that system can do additional things like maybe output this information in a report or use it downstream. So simply returning freeform text like this will not be very useful. But thankfully, we can force that response to be consistent by using an output parser. Let's go to add nodes, then go to output parsers, and here we have a few options. We can return the response as a CSV output, we can return it as a list, a structured output parser, or an advanced structured output parser. Let's add the structured output parser. I'm going to enable autofix as that seems to give the best possible response. Then within additional parameters, we can set the exact values that we'd like to return. So let's add a new item, and let's call this first one invoice_number, which is of type number. And for the description, we can enter something like the invoice number. The large language model will use this description to figure out how to extract that information from the document. Let's add a new item. Let's call this one customer number, which is also of type number, and for the description, let's enter the customer number. And finally, let's add one more field. Let's call this gross amount including VAT. And for the type, let's select number, and in the description, let's say the gross amount including VAT. Cool. Now let's attach the output parser to our chain like so. Let's save the flow, and in the chat window, let's upload our file. Let's say go. We now receive a JSON structure, and these field names will be consistent every time we call the service, and the values follow the exact types that we defined. For example, the gross amount now simply returns the amount itself without the currency. If we wanted to return the currency as well, we could simply go to additional parameters. Let's add amount currency. Let's change the type to string. And for the description, let's enter the gross amount currency. Let's save this. Let's run this again. So I'll clear the chat. Let's upload the file and let's say go. And this time we also get the currency back. Now, these type of flows can actually be incredibly powerful. You don't have to necessarily extract information from an invoice for this to make sense. You can use the same chain to build sentiment analysis workflows. You can classify different documents based on the content within those documents, etc. Now, it's time to move on to the next project.